I feel like I'm always out there, and for once I want to be invisible and low-key and like nobody knows me and all that stuff. My family is very traditional, so I wish they would be able to accept me more and like be able to tolerate me more. That I like to party, that I like to dance and be surrounded by like different kinds of people and all that stuff. I'm Asian, so it's very different. I think in New York, like, I've made a lot of really good friendships.
I would want to know if I like have to fuck everyone that I know now before I die, or if I like can wait it out. You know what I mean? I just hope it's not like painfully. You know what I mean? Like, I hope it's just like in my sleep or something. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I hope I don't get like killed or like shot or something like that.
Like skydiving or like bungee jump. You know?
Why are you doing that now?
Cause I'm scared. It's frightening, and I'm poor.
My most treasured memory is living in South America in Venezuela when I was 8 years old with my mom under poverty, getting tear gas thrown at us and us saying we need a better life in a better country. So we moved to the US, we packed our bags and left with $500 in a dream. And it's making it here, and now I'm standing here by myself. And I grew up to be like a tougher person and like learn how to handle hard situations on my own without anybody's help, which I love.
I just moved to the city and my bills went up and I was just like forget about my job and just lose it, and it's a lot. Living here is tough, you know.
Well, me and my mom are best friends. I'm so happy and proud about that. And like she knows everything basically, and I'm so happy for that. She's the best woman in the world. And like I look up to her just being like a Boricua woman from the Bronx, like fucking like sacrificing so much for me as a first child, and I just want to repay that. Like, I'm trying to like live through that and like be like, I got you, and I hope one day I can like repay everything that you've done for me.
Alright, so my greatest accomplishments was basically just taking acid, because like it literally changed my life for better. So I can finally see myself in a different perspective.
And maybe get answers to questions I never understood I had the answers to.
Looking through someone else's eyes, even though you don't understand it, is the best accomplishment you can feel, because even if you don't understand it, the minute you go into someone's shoes, it's like a brand new world for you. Even if you don't feel it, even if you didn't grow from it, even if you don't have the culture from it, stepping into someone's shoes, you can finally understand their struggles, their pain, their accomplishments, their failures and success. And I feel like that is the best accomplishment, just to be connected to someone. If I was just at home, fucking whatever, doing stupid shit that everyone thinks that I could be doing, because I'm just a statistic, I'm just like this color, it's like, I don't know, this is the greatest accomplishment, being out here, connecting with everybody, and feeling everything else. Like, this is cool, like, I'm out of my comfort zone, this is what it's all about, like, this is what it's all about. First, you know, when I came out to him, yeah, like, last week, so it was pretty cool.
Awesome.
To be honest, we're all one, we're all the same thing.